بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. I want to extend my condolences to myself but also to this entire ummah. عظم الله أجركم. May Allah exalt your reward in the loss of really one of the great Muslims of our time, and really I believe one of the great Muslims for all time, and that's our brother, the great statesman, the great humanitarian, the greatest sportsman of the 20th century, Muhammad Ali. Muhammad Ali, may Allah have mercy on his soul, was an extraordinary human being destined for greatness and recognized early on. His mother said that she knew God had plans for him. He learned to speak before he was 1 year old, which is very unusual for a child. He was gifted with incredible intellect, with extraordinary wit. He was once in a restaurant and he was told that we don't serve Negroes here. And he said, that's perfectly all right with me. I don't eat them. And I think that really exemplifies the incredible spirit of that man. Muhammad Ali Clay, I think in a more just time, would probably have been one of the great political scientists or intellectuals of our time. But he was born into an unjust condition for African Americans, and he made the best of that situation. And I think one of the reasons why he's so beloved around the world, first and foremost, is because our Prophet ﷺ said, if God loves somebody, that he announces it to the angels, and then he tells the angels to put that love of that person in the hearts of humanity. And I think that that's a proof that he was beloved by God, وَلَا نُزَكِّي عَلَى اللَّهِ, and that he was from the people of God. He entered into the Nation of Islam, but he was so much bigger than any group. He never left his religion. He became an Orthodox Muslim, and he made it very clear that he wanted to be buried as a Muslim. He was a devout and pious person that read the Quran. Those who knew him and were close to him knew that he was very committed to studying the Quran. Anybody that watches his talks can see the brilliance of the man, but also the deep humanity of the man. I think that he had a child's heart in its purity, that he genuinely loved people. And that love is what inevitably won even his enemies over. It's quite extraordinary that the people that he knocked down and defeated in the ring were some of the people that loved him the most, like George Foreman, who actually said that that was one of the most important things that ever happened to him, being defeated by Muhammad Ali. All of the braggadocio that Muhammad Ali displayed, anyone that watches him knows that it was done just as a wonderful aspect of his entertaining nature, that he enjoyed to make people laugh and to make people feel good. He is a great loss for our community. He was committed to Islam until the end, and he was defending our religion against extremists. So may Allah reward him, grant him the highest place in Jannah. My brother Harun Sellers wrote that although he was impressed by the 37 men that Muhammad Ali knocked down, what's more impressive is all the people he lifted up.